My grandpa, when I was 11, came out to Milwaukee, where my family's from, and went with my mom to the genetic counselor in Milwaukee. And we're both tested for Huntington's disease, and he actually tested gene positive, and very fortunately, my mom tested gene negative. When my grandpa attempted suicide shortly after he was diagnosed, and I just remember afterwards, we really struggled finding someone to provide him with the right care, the right meds to keep his, you know, his emotions and his behavior sort of balanced and help him out. And it was there that I kind of realized, you know, I want to be that person that can help a family like mine. My name's Jolene Luther, and I'm going to be a senior here at the University of Iowa this year. We're currently in the hospital where I'm doing my fellowship that I was given by the Huntington's Disease Society of America. I had worked with Sean Thompson, who is the public relations coordinator at the Center of Excellence. He had actually emailed me. I was in Spain studying abroad for the year and said, hey, I found this. I know that, you know, undergraduates can apply. You have to make up a proposal, and I don't know if you'd be interested or if you have time, but in case you are. Research isn't something I'd really considered before. I'd always thought about clinical care, but I just wanted to go for it and try and see what would come of it. It seemed like such an incredible opportunity to me that it was hard to wrap my head around being able to do something that exciting. And I was in Spain at the time living with my Spanish host mom. And I was in my room and I opened my email and saw the notification and just was like screaming, jumping, so excited. And she came into my room like, oh no, what's happening? I was like, I got the fellowship. And so we were really excited. I called my mom and she was really proud. So it was definitely an exciting time.
Jolene has been a fabulous addition to the lab. I'm very proud of her willingness to step forth in this disease and to say, I want to make a difference. Many families with the disease know that there is stigmatization and discrimination about having a genetic illness in the family. And also it's painful. It's painful to be with our loved ones when they're sick. So many people don't have the strength and courage that Jolene has shown in saying, I want to work in this and make a difference. So the research project Jolene has been working on is trying to look at what we call the white matter changes in the brain. She is going through hundreds of scans, looking at brain scans when she didn't know what a brain scan looked like before she started, and becoming an expert at understanding the brain scans, understanding the different types of tissue in the brain scan, understanding what tissue may look abnormal and should be marked as something that we should quantify and move forward.
In large part, what I'm looking for is iron deposition in the brain. So with diseases like Huntington's disease, it's been found that as the disease progresses, not necessarily after you're diagnosed, but even before, there is increased amounts of iron accumulating in certain areas of the brain. We're looking for those areas in the brain and seeing if they're associated with other things. Potentially, if I find the same things that these other studies have found in the past with our data, it could kind of be a flag to say, hey, maybe we want to look at this for clinical trials so that they could develop some treatment that would target that iron accumulation and stop it from happening as the disease progresses. My ideal situation for the future, you know, being able to work with HD patients, but maybe working with research as well, which before this project really wasn't something I'd considered. And so this has kind of, you know, awakened that hunger in me for research. It's been a super rewarding experience and I've learned so much and it's been really great.
I really hope to continue to see her in this field. And if not in this field, no matter what field she ends up in, she will make a difference because she has that really unique blend of compassion, for the topic, as well as the knowledge and intelligence to see it through. So I really have strong hopes for her continuing to be a colleague in the future and working with us on advancing our knowledge of Huntington's disease.